Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvendi. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 11.2. We continue on the impact of jet. In the previous lecture, we discussed about the impact of jet. And this lecture also, we continue with the impact of jet. This is the second lecture on the impact of jet. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the Euler's equation, theory of rotodynamic machines, the various efficiencies, velocity components at the entry and exit of the rotor, and we will draw the velocity triangle for rotodynamic machine. And the learning outcome for the student at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to describe the components of velocity vector, draw the inlet and the outlet velocity triangles of the rotodynamic machine, and define various efficiency of rotodynamic machine. We will continue with the impact of jet. So, in the earlier lecture, we calculated the work done for on the stationary vertical plate, inclined plate with a stationary plate or moving plate and curved plate. So, we continue here, and here we are going to discuss the jet strikes the curved plate at one end when the plate is unsymmetrical. So, in the earlier lecture, we studied about the symmetrical blading where the angle on both sides are equal. Now, here the angles are different here. So, you take the horizontal direction of the x axis or the horizontal direction, and now the plate is unsymmetrical. So, look at the theta is the inlet angle and the phi is the outlet angle. These two are different. And the jet, as usual, it is moving with a velocity, it is flowing with a velocity v, with the diameter d, which is striking on the bottom end of the plate, and it is flowing along the direction of the plate and is getting deflected on the other side. Now, the plate is stationary, it is not moving, so the plate is stationary. So, we have to calculate the horizontal and the vertical forces of the water on the plate. So, let the theta is the angle made by the tangent at the tip of the at the inlet tip with the x axis, and phi is the angle made by the tangent at the outlet tip with the x axis. So, theta and phi are the angles. And force exerted by the jet in the direction of the jet. So, we calculate Fx equal to mass per second into Vx1 minus Vx2. And Vx1 is the initial velocity in the direction of the jet, V cos theta. And Vx2 is the final velocity in the direction of the jet minus V cos phi. And now we calculate, substitute for Vx1, Vx2 here. And Fx equal to rho a v into v cos theta plus v cos phi. So, that is equal to rho a v square into cos theta plus cos phi. Now, the force exerted by the jet in the perpendicular direction. So, Fy equal to mass per second into Vy1 minus Vy2, where Vy1 equal to initial velocity in the direction of the jet, v sin theta, and Vy2 is the final velocity in the direction of the jet equal to v sin phi. So, substituting in the equation, V Fy equal to rho a v into sin theta minus sin phi, which is Fy equal to rho a v square into sin theta minus sin phi. So, this is the force exerted by the jet in the perpendicular direction, and the Fx is the force exerted by the jet in the horizontal direction or the direction of the jet. The next topic, the force exerted by the jet on the moving curved plate. So, we take the moving curved plate. Now, the jet is striking at the center of the plate and the plate is moving with a velocity u. So, the jet velocity is capital V and diameter of the jet equal to small d, and the plate is moving with a velocity u, and here it is symmetrical blade where the theta angle theta is equal on both sides about the center of the jet or the center of the plate. Now, V is the velocity of the jet, u is the velocity of the plate, a is the cross sectional area of the jet. The jet strikes the plate with a relative velocity v minus u. Now, this velocity can be resolved into two directions. The velocity in the direction of the jet minus v minus u cos theta. The velocity in the perpendicular direction v minus u sin theta. Now, the mass of the water which is striking the plate equal to rho a v minus u. So, rho a into velocity v minus u. And the force exerted by the jet of water on the curved plate in the direction of the jet. So, the horizontal direction, the force exerted by the jet of water on the curved plate in the direction of the jet. So mass per second, fx equal to mass per second into change in velocity. So mass per second equal to rho a into v minus u, and initial velocity is v minus u, and final velocity is also v minus u, but it is negative. So this becomes rho a v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta. So the fx, the force in the horizontal direction is rho a into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta. And similarly, work done by the jet in the per second, this equal to mass, the fx, the force into distance traveled by the plate in the direction x direction. So rho a into v minus u whole square 1 plus cos theta into u. So this will be rho a into v minus u whole square into u into 1 plus cos theta. So u is the velocity of the plate in the horizontal direction. Now, this is the next topic, the force exerted by the jet of water on an unsymmetrical moving curved plate when the jet strikes the tangentially at one tip. So, this is jet is striking here and it is moving, the jet is flowing along the plate and the plate is unsymmetrical. We have two angles theta and phi, and the plate is also moving with a velocity u. The curved plate is also moving with a velocity u. Now, we draw the inlet and the outlet velocity triangle. So, we have different velocity here. So, we take the diagram we just explained here. So, v is the absolute velocity of the jet at the inlet, and the absolute velocity has got two components. One is horizontal component, tangential component vw, and the vertical component vf. So, this is the flow direction, this is the tangential direction. And the u is the speed of the plate. So, the velocity of the plate is u. So, the vectorial sum of u and v, so velocity of the jet and velocity of the plate, it is called as relative velocity vr. So, vr is the relative velocity of the jet, so with angle theta. So, theta is the angle of the blade at the inlet, angle of the curved plate at the inlet, and alpha is the angle of the jet at the inlet. Now, the jet is flowing, moving along the plate on the surface of the plate and leaving on the other side, and it is leaving with the relative velocity vr1 with an angle phi. So, phi is the angle of the blade at the outlet, and the vr1, it has got the plate, again, once again the plate is moving with the velocity u. So, the vectorial sum of vr1 and u is the absolute velocity of the jet v1. So, absolute velocity v1, and it has got two components, the tangential component vw1 and the vertical component or the flow component vf1, and the angle is beta. So, the angle made by the the absolute velocity equal to beta. Now, this is the exit velocity triangle or the velocity triangle at the outlet, and this is the inlet velocity triangle. Now, we take various parameters. U is the velocity of the plate. So, u equal to u1 equal to u2 equal to pi dn by 60, where d is the diameter of the rotor and n is the speed. So, normally we calculate the rotor diameter and the speed of the rotor divided by 60. V1 is the absolute velocity of the fluid at the inlet, and Vf1 is the flow velocity at the inlet, vertical component of V1. Vr1 is the relative velocity at the inlet, and Vw1 is the tangential velocity at the inlet, which is viral component or the viral velocity, horizontal component of V1. Similarly, V2, Vf2, Vr2, Vw2 are the velocities at the outlet. Theta is the angle of the plate at the inlet tip. Phi is the angle of the plate at the outlet tip. Alpha is the angle of absolute velocity at the inlet. Guide vane angle or nozzle angle at the inlet. Beta is the angle of the absolute velocity at the outlet. So, guide blade angle at the outlet. So, these are all the notations we use for our calculation. So, the mass of the fluid striking the plate per second. So, rho A into V of 1. So, rho A is the density of the fluid. A is the cross-sectional area of the jet. And V of 1 is the flow velocity. Velocity in the flow direction, and the initial velocity with which the jet strikes in the direction of the motion. So, Vr1 cos theta, which is equal to Vw1 minus u from the inlet velocity triangle. Similarly, the final velocity of the jet in the direction of the motion minus Vr2 cos phi, which is minus of u plus Vw2, again from the velocity outlet velocity triangle. Now, the force exerted by the jet in the direction of the motion, this is equal to mass of the water striking per second into change in velocity. So, this is equal to mass equal to rho a into v of 1, and the initial velocity is vw1 minus u, and final velocity is minus of u plus vw. So, the u is getting cancelled here, and the equation will become rho a v f 1 into v w 1 plus v w 2. So this is the force exerted by the jet in the direction of the motion, and the work done per second on the vane by the jet equal to the force into distance moved by the moved in the direction of the force. So distance moved by the plate in the direction of the force. So rho a v f 1 into v w 1 plus v w 2 into u. So this is the work done. The unit is joules per second or watts, and this equation we will be using for calculating the power required for the centrifugal pump or power produced by the hydraulic turbine in the coming chapters. So this is the very much the final component, final equation or the final topic on the impact of jet. It is very much closer to the real time turbo machine, real time hydrodynamic machine. So we developed from the flat plate, fixed flat plate, moving flat plate, fixed curved plate, asymmetrical curved plate, symmetrical curved plate, moving symmetrical curved plate, and finally we take the plate which is asymmetrical, very much closer to the real time hydrodynamic machine. And this final equation is very important, which will be used in the future for calculating the work done in the case of centrifugal pump and the hydraulic turbines. And we'll discuss about the theory of rotodynamic machines. So here I am describing the velocity with the component C, which is common to all types of turbo machines. So C is the velocity. C1 is the absolute velocity. It has got the three component CX1, CW1 and CR1. So CX1 is in the axial direction parallel to the axis. CR1. So CR1 is the radial component perpendicular to the axis, and CW1 is the tangential component which is tangent to the wheel, rotating wheel, and R1 is the inlet radius, R2 is the outlet radius at the outlet. Similarly, at the outlet we have C2 is the absolute velocity. It has got three components: horizontal component CX2, vertical component CR2, and the tangential component CW2. So we discuss about the energy exchange and velocity component. The energy exchange equation for rotodynamic machines like pump or the turbine is derived with the following assumptions. The mass flow rate of the fluid is constant. So m equal to constant, rho a v1 equal to rho a v2, and the state of the fluid at any given point is constant. So the condition, the properties of the fluid, it is constant. There is no chemical reaction within the machine, and there is no leakage losses in the machine, and the energy transfer in the machine is constant. So energy transfer is also constant. These are all the assumptions for our calculating the energy exchange and the velocity components. The basic equation for energy transfer in a rotodynamic machine is obtained by applying Newton's law of motion for fluid flowing through the machine. So Newton's second law of motion, F equal to m into a. The fluid enters in the rotor with the radius r1 with the velocity c1 and leaves the rotor with the radius r2 with the velocity c2. The velocity vector has three components mutually perpendicular to each other, namely axial component Cx, which is parallel to the axis of the machine, radial component Cr, which is perpendicular to the axis of the machine, and tangential component or the viral component Cw, which is at the right angle to the radial direction. So Newton's law of motion states that the rate of change of angular momentum is equal to all applied forces to the rotor, that is the net torque on the rotor. So the F equal to m into a. Rate of change of momentum is equal to net force acting on the plate, acting on the machine. So for constant mass flow rate of m kilograms per second, the torque on the rotor is given by torque equal to m into r1 cw1 minus r2 cw2. So when the velocity c1 c2 they are changing, c1 is the absolute velocity of the jet at the inlet, c2 is the absolute velocity of the jet at the outlet. So in the direction of the flow from the inlet to the outlet of the machine, the velocities are changing. So for example in the case of turbine, it is entering with the higher kinetic energy and leaving with the lower kinetic energy. There is decrease in the kinetic energy. In the case of centrifugal pump, the fluid enters with the lower velocity and leaving with the higher velocity. So velocity is increasing. So when the absolute velocity is increasing or decreasing, that is changing, the three components of velocity are also changing. The axial component is changing, radial component is changing, and tangential component is also changing. So the change in which component is giving useful work output. So the change in the axial component, it gives the axial thrust to the machine. The change in radial component, it gives the radial force on the machine. The change in tangential component, it is what the useful work output. So the change in the axial component, there will be force acting in the along the direction of the axis. The change in the radial component, there will be force acting perpendicular to the axis of the machine. So these two components, they are acting on the shaft, which is taken care, they are not giving any useful effect on the work done, they are taken care by the bearing, end bearing. So the machine, the shaft of the machine is supported by the end bearing. These two forces, change in the axial force, change in the radial force, they are taken care by the end bearing. So in the design of machine element, so you may be studying the design of machine element, the design of machine element for the journal bearing or the thrust bearing, you will be considering two forces, one is axial force and the radial force. So these are all the two forces in the case of rotodynamic machine. So the change in the velocity, it causes change in the axial velocity, change in the radial velocity, and change in the whirl velocity. The change in the axial velocity and the radial velocity, they are taken care by the bearing, and the change in the whirl velocity, that is what giving useful work output. So it is given here, R1 CW1 minus R2 CW2, this is the change in velocity into mass of the fluid. And the rate of energy transfer is the product of net torque into angular velocity. So E equal to energy transfer, E equal to M into R1 CW1 minus R2 CW2 into omega, which is equal to M into U1 CW1 minus U2 CW2. So U1, U2 are the peripheral speed. So peripheral speed U equal to omega into R. Omega is the angular velocity in radians per second, and R is the radius in meters. So this becomes meters per second. So the mass flow rate, for unit mass flow rate, the energy equation becomes E equal to U1 CW1 minus U2 CW2. The above equation is known as Euler's equation, which is the basic energy transfer equation for all rotary hydraulic machines. So this equation will be using for calculating work done in the case of centrifugal pump and the hydraulic turbine. So here we are mentioned the C is the velocity in the, well, C is the velocity, whereas in the hydraulic machine will be using notation V for velocity. So this equation is common for all kinds of rotary machines. And the energy transfer equation implies that the change in angular momentum of the fluid, and this may be positive or negative. So in the case of turbine, this will be positive. In the case of pump, this is negative. So the turbine is a hydraulic turbine is a work producing machine or power producing hydrodynamic machine, whereas the pump is the power absorbing rotodynamic or hydrodynamic machine. For hydraulic turbine, the value is positive, and for the hydraulic pump, the value is negative. And we resolve the velocity, we draw the velocity triangle. So this is the rotor of the hydrodynamic machine, which is rotating with the angular velocity omega, and the velocity C1 is the absolute velocity of the inlet. It has got the two components, CW1 and CX1, and the CR1 is the relative velocity of the fluid, which is vectorial sum of U1 and C1, and similarly the fluid is leaving with the velocity CR2 at the outlet, and with the U2 is the peripheral speed, CW2 is the whirl velocity of absolute velocity C2, and CX is the velocity in the x direction or the axial direction. Now from the inlet velocity triangle, we take CX1 square using the Pythagoras theorem, CX1 square equal to C1 square minus CW1 square. So C1 square minus CW1 square, or using the other part, CX1 square equal to CR1 square minus U1 minus CW1 whole square. So this length, U1 minus CW1 whole square. Similarly, using the two equations, so C1 square minus CW1 square equal to CR1 square minus U1 minus CW1 whole square. So left hand side as it is, C1 square minus CW1 square, right hand side first term as it is, CR1 square, and this is expanded, minus U1 square minus CW1 square plus 2U1 CW1. So now we take the 2U1 CW1, so U1 CW1 equal to 1 by 2 C1 square. CW1 square is getting cancelled. We have negative CW1 square left hand side, right hand side, that is getting cancelled. So 1 by 2 C1 square plus U1 square minus CR1 square. So C1 square is the change in the absolute velocity of the inlet. u1 square is the velocity kinetic energy due to the peripheral speed, and cr1 is the kinetic energy due to the relative velocity. So similarly, from the outlet velocity triangle, we may write u2 cw2 equal to 1 by 2 c2 square plus u2 square minus cr2 square. Now we have u1 cw1 equal to 1 by 2 c1 square plus u1 square minus cr1 square. U2 cw2 equal to 1 by 2 c2 square plus u2 square minus cr2 square. Now we substitute these two equations in the Euler's equation. So Euler's equation becomes E equal to u1 cw1 minus u2 cw2. Substituting for u1 cw1 and u2 cw2, this will become 1 by 2 c1 square plus u1 square minus cr1 square minus c2 square plus u2 square minus cr2 square. Rearranging the terms, this will be 1 by 2 c1 square minus c2 square plus 1 by 2 u1 square minus u2 square plus 1 by 2 cr2 square minus cr1 square. Now in the above equation, we have 1 by 2 c1 square minus c2 square, which is the change in absolute kinetic energy or dynamic head occurring in the machine. And 1 by 2 u1 square minus u2 square is the change in the centrifugal energy of the fluid. And 1 by 2 cr2 square minus cr1 square, this is the change in the kinetic energy due to the change in relative velocity of the fluid. So these are all the three components of velocity in the Euler's equation. And finally we define the efficiency of the rotodynamic machine. So for the hydraulic efficiency is the ratio of work done on the rotor to the energy supplied to the energy of the jet. So eta h equal to work done on the rotor divided by energy of the jet. And mechanical efficiency is defined as the ratio of actual work available at the rotor to the energy imparted to the rotor. So mechanical efficiency eta mech equal to work available at the output shaft of the rotor divided by work imparted on the rotor. Then we calculate the volumetric efficiency is defined as the quantity of liquid discharged from the pump per second to the quantity of liquid passing per second through the rotor. So eta v, volumetric efficiency, equal to liquid discharged from the pump per second divided by quantity of liquid passing through the rotor per second. So all these efficiency we'll be calculating for pump and the turbine separately, but this is the basic equation, the fundamental equation for calculating the three important efficiencies: hydraulic efficiency, mechanical efficiency and volumetric efficiency for the rotodynamic machines. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in the mechanical engineering subject, and you may find the fluid mechanics and machinery. You can refer to the book for further information on the subject. I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject, and the solution for the gate question papers are also uploaded in the YouTube channel. You can subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. And thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You subscribe the channel, and you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. I will answer your queries. We'll meet again in the next video lecture with the problem on impact of jet.